What is up, New Beginnings Church? Happy Friday to you. Thank God it is Friday, but let's close strong. Let's finish off this week strong. As a matter of fact, this whole week we've been really dissecting a prayer that the Apostle Paul prays over the Church of Ephesus, and I've just decided this is the stuff that I need to be praying over you, New Beginnings, and also I just want to be incorporating this into my own personal prayer life. And so we've talked about these little things that we need to put in there, a spirit of revelation, a spirit of wisdom, walking with God so that I might know Him. Yesterday we talked about power, right? That there's a power that comes from God, and the same power that raised Christ from the dead dwells in me now. But the end of this, it's almost not something that you pray for, but it's a new awareness that you kind of get into. And he's going to show you how, like, if you'll become more aware of Jesus's authority over this stuff, it's just going to help you live life better. And here's, you'll see what I'm talking about here. So remember, we just prayed for power. So I'm going to pick up there and then keep reading down. It says, the power is the same as the mighty strength that he exerted when he raised Christ from the dead and seated him at the right hand in the heavenly realms, far above all rule and authority, power and dominion, and every name that is invoked, not only in the present age, but also in the one to come. And God placed all things under his feet and appointed him to be head over everything for the church, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills everything in every way. Wow. You may need to take those few verses and read them about three times and then think about all this. This is like how my wife can sometimes pack a suitcase where you stuff so much in there that you can't close it. The Apostle Paul has stuffed so much stuff into these few verses, it's going to be almost impossible for me to get through it all, but let me try to like gloss over it. When he says that Christ is raised from the dead and seated at the right hand of the Father, you remember that's an ancient type imagery because the king would have, you know, in essence, a person at his right hand who he empowered and gave authority to make all decisions in the realm of the kingdom, right? And so he's saying that's where Jesus is. Jesus, by conquering sin and death, has authority over everything. As a matter of fact, that's what it says. It says literally, he is the head over everything, that all things have been put underneath his authority, right? So what all does that mean? Well, he tells you. The first thing he says is that heavenly realms, like far above authority, power, dominion, and every name that is invoked. Well, that power, authority, and dominion can mean like earthly dominions, earthly governments, earthly powers, but it also kind of alludes to the idea of like spiritual wickedness, right? So later in Ephesians 6, he says the same thing. He goes that we don't wrestle against flesh and blood. Actually, there's spiritual wickedness in heavenly realms, and he uses these same words. And so in one way, Jesus rules and reigns over every earthly government, but he also rules and reigns over every spiritual wickedness in heavenly realms. And so that's there. Number two is this. He says that he's authority over everything in this present age, but also in the one to come, which means that not only does he rule and reign over spiritual wickedness or earthly governments, he rules and reigns even over time itself. So whatever you got in this present age, whatever is going to happen in the age to come, he goes, yeah, he's got that too. Here's another one, the church. Jesus is head over the church. And that's why every pastor in every church, we take our cues from Jesus. We take all of our teaching from Jesus, and that is the center point. His life, his death, his resurrection, that's the pinnacle of the whole thing. It is Jesus. That's why we're called Christians, is because we follow Jesus. Can I get an amen to that? And then watch this. Even after he says he's head over the church, he goes, the fullness of him who fills everything in every way. I mean, trying to get my head wrapped around this is a little mind-boggling here, but what he's saying is this, is that Jesus is the authority over everything, spiritual things, earthly things, kingdoms, dominions, names, this time period, that time period, the church, spiritual wick, everything. But then he makes you aware of even maybe how deep it goes. He goes, the fullness of Jesus who fills everything in every way. He's saying, I need you to have a greater level of awareness that God is filling all things, that God was not just a creator that made something, flung it out into the universe, spun it on its axis and said, good luck, but actually that he is connected to his creation, that he's engaged, he's involved, he's active. I mean, this God is not standing outside of the chaos watching it take place, but he's actively engaging in it. If nothing proves that more, it's the cross. It's that Jesus is saying, hey, I'm not going to let you suffer and let sin and evil run rampant. I'm going to engage. I'm going to actually write myself into the story and let you know I'm not absent from your pain or your suffering. I'm not absent from sinfulness and wickedness. As a matter of fact, I'll take the whole thing on, which is why he says, of course, in Corinthians, that he who knew no sin became sin that we might become the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. Like, God is not standing on the outside watching things. He's actively engaged, filling the whole thing, drawing the whole thing back to him and back to ultimate redemption, which is what we call heaven. And so anyway, church, just be encouraged. As we added all these things to our prayer life, yes, but in light of the fact that Jesus is ruling and reigning over it all. Can I get an amen? So church, be encouraged today. There's nothing that's caught God off guard. There's nothing that's ever surprised God. God's never wrung his hands with nervousness or stressfulness. He's got the whole thing under control. Can I get an amen? Let's be confident in our God today. Amen. Church, I love you so much. I'll see you on Sunday morning. Have a great weekend.